Hey, this is Thomas Brooks, the developer of lithophanemaker.com, and this is a lunar lamp. Let me show it to you. That wasn't quite right. Maybe I should try this. That wasn't this lamp. There we go. It's getting lit in here. So if you'd like to learn how to do that complicated dance to turn the sucker on, I will leave a link in the description. If you'd like to learn how to make this, then just stay tuned. I mean, I could just flip the switch.
So now we're in the Lithophane Sphere Maker, and you can see you can put all your settings in over here on the left, and then on the right you can mess around with the CAD model. And this is just a CAD model of the moon. Now, you can update this model with whatever you've designed here, but it will be a low-resolution version. It's not going to look as good as the final lithophane that you make will look. So I uploaded my picture, and I selected moon background, and I selected crop, and all of these other settings that you see down here. Then I cropped my picture, so now I'm ready to create the STL. So I go down here to the bottom and I just hit Create STL. Now at this screen you see some items that are affiliate links, so that if you buy these items through these links, then you're supporting the hosting and continued development of lithophanemaker.com. So please consider doing that. You can see that the file has been created here, so I just hit save. And before we go to slicing, I'm going to talk through all those settings that we just looked at and that I kind of glanced over. So in order to see what your design looks like before you actually create the STL, you use this CAD view over here on the right, and you can left click in there and rotate the CAD object around. On the left, you have all of your settings. You have moon background, which if that is checked, then it'll make all of the sphere that doesn't have your picture on it be the texturing of the moon, so it'll look like the moon. You can flip the image and that'll rotate the image 180 degrees so that you can have the cylinder on top instead of being on bottom. You can crop the image, which allows you to control the angular height as well as the angular width of the image. And then down here you have the lithophane resolution. That's the same as all of the other tools. What that is it's the distance between unique heights on the lithophane surface. So the smaller that number is, the shorter the distance between unique heights, and the greater the resolution of your lithophane. Then you have the sphere diameter, which is pretty self-explanatory. It's the diameter of the sphere. You have the picture angular height and the picture angular width. And this picture is going to be mapped onto the sphere. So instead of having a distance, we have angles. So you can think of this like longitude and latitude. An angular height of 90 means that the picture will go from 45 degrees above the equator down to 45 degrees below the equator. And then the angular width is just the same thing, except for in the other dimension. So now you have the maximum thickness and the minimum thickness, and those control the contrast and the brightness of your lithophane. The correct value for those depends on which filament you want to use. And this is a good number if you're using an eSun Cool White, which I have in my store and which is what I personally use and recommend. And then you have the cylinder outer diameter. So if I hit update design here, then this design will update to the design that I currently have selected on the left side of the page. And it'll just take a moment because it's creating the STL file, and then it's sending the STL file to my computer right now just to be viewed in this viewer. So this does take a moment. I'm thinking about ways to make that a little bit better. So the STL model has loaded, and here it is. I can look around at it, and here's the picture of the baby. You can see down here at the bottom, there's the cylinder. So the outer diameter of the cylinder is the diameter right here where the cylinder and the sphere intersect. So you can see that if the diameter of the cylinder were larger, then the cylinder would move up the sphere. This means that as you change the diameter of that cylinder, the available angular height starts to decrease. Initially, the available angular height is 180 degrees from the South Pole to the North Pole, but as the cylinder comes in, it starts to decrease. And then the cylinder height is the distance from the base of the cylinder right here to that intersection point between the cylinder and the sphere. Now the cylinder thickness is the radial thickness of it. The cylinder ledge outer diameter is the diameter of this outermost ledge. So you really need that to be greater than the cylinder outer diameter for it to make any sense. I selected a cylinder outer diameter that would be large enough for me to fit a bulb that I already have into this hole here. Now the top hole outer diameter is currently set to zero, so there's no top hole. So to be honest with you, this CAD viewing thing that I have over here on the right doesn't work as well as I would like it to work. So I'm considering going back to the regular design schematic sort of approach for this, and then also potentially creating a standalone program that you can install on your machine. And if you think those would help, please let me know in the comments. Now, those are all the settings, and of course you have this X shift, Y shift. You can scoot this guy over. You have to click away in order for it to scoot over. I can scoot the cropping rectangle over to the left or to the right, or put it back in the center again. I've written out a bunch of instructions here at the bottom, so if you have any questions, you can consult those, or you can join the lithophanemaker.com users group on Facebook. So now I'm going to show you how I sliced it. I'm going to use the exact same slicer settings that I always use, and I've talked about before in, for example, the Lithophane Lightbox tutorial. I'm not going to use any support, even though we have basically an overhang of 90 degrees up here at the very top. So I'm just going to hit prepare. So it has completed slicing, and you can see it's going to take a day and 14 hours cure time, as I say. So that's probably more like a day and 20 hours or so. And it's going to take 190 kilograms of filament. So the first thing I always do when I slice something is I turn on layer view, which you can change up here in the top right. And then I kind of scroll down the layers and I look at the cross sections and just make sure that it all looks hunky-dory and it makes sense. Also, when you're in layer view, you're able to see if there are any holes in the lithophane. And you can check out that any print artifacts are caused by the printer as opposed to being caused by the G-code. Because it's possible for your slicer to tell the printer to do something that will not make the final lithophane look good. So we want to make sure that's not happening. So with a big file like this, it can take a while to look at things in layer view. You just have to be patient. So I'm looking around at this layer right here, and it looks like it's all very well filled in. Not seeing anything strange, like repeating lines going up and down the inside or the outside. So now, of course, you just save the file to an SD card or to your computer, then upload it to Octoprint, and then you print it.
So after you're done printing it, this is what you get. This lamp can be bought on Amazon.com, and I'll leave a link in the description. And that link will be an affiliate link, so it'll help pay for my own lamp here that I bought. And for all the studio equipment I use, and for the continued hosting and development of lithophanemaker.com. And if you'd really like to support lithophanemaker.com in a big way, you could become a patron. Because let me tell it to you straight. If I spent all this money without getting anything back, my wife would kill me. So please, please keep me from dying by going down into the description and becoming a patron on Patreon. That would be excellent because I love to live. And outside of that, I also run off of the jollies that I get whenever somebody likes and subscribes to my YouTube channel. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. Now I'm going to show you the full list of my current patrons. If you ever see them in a 3D printing forum, be sure to thank them for being spectacular individuals that keep lithophanemaker.com going. So I hope you found this tutorial useful, and I will see you next time.